Welcome to the Iron Horse Route, home of the Denver Rio Grand Western. This is Brian. I'm glad you're here. And if you're not already a subscriber, I want to encourage you to subscribe, because when you're a subscriber here, you get access to a lot of great model railroad video uploads. And so now that you're subscribed, we invite you to sit back, relax, and enjoy today's video upload, which is coming up right now. Hey, welcome back from the intro. This is part three of Uncle Digger's Cabin, and what I'm doing right now is showing you the model that's almost ready to be assembled right now. I'm getting ready to paint that in this clip right here. That's the first thing I'm going to do. I'm going to paint this, and then we're going to assemble it. I want to show you. We've got the brown walls, brown base. I have already painted the chimneys gray. I have painted the window panels. I didn't show the window panels in the first two episodes because we were still fine-tuning everything, but now I've got the indentions cut out, and any of the models printed prior to now don't have the window indentions cut in them yet. I just hadn't made it that far. And also, we have a new development. The walls have been, the sizes of the walls have been changed. These two guys right here have been changed by 0.25 millimeters is all. Right here, there has been an addition. Underneath the roof, it kind of looks crazy, but this outside, and I'm going to be able to cut this out, the 3D printers, because it was face down, leaves a little bit of flash there. I can just cut that right out. There's actually a cavity all the way around on the outside. And what that does is, this is where it seats down onto the walls. Okay. And then this one right here is a new development. All right. This is where the new inserts go in. They glue in right here. All right. I don't think I have the right one there, but you get the point. The inserts glue in right there, all right? And then what happens is, once they're secure, they actually help to hold the roof on and in place really good. The two inserts actually match this way, I think. Hold on. I'll have to look. I gotta take some flash off right there. But they actually come together at an angle. All right, like your the eave of your roof, all right, underneath. And they don't glue together, but they should sit together snugly, and then you shouldn't have any light go through, and the roof's units will come off like a top. All right, so what we'll do is, in this video, is first we're going to be mixing the paint for the airbrush. We'll be airbrushing these walls, this burnt sienna color. I think that's going to be a nice color to go with these. All right. What we'll do after that is, we'll probably stop the video, come back in and do another coat, allow this to dry, come back in, and we'll do a video showing where we put the window panels into the window frames. Once that dries, we'll put the window frames and panels into the openings of the walls. Then we'll flip it over, and we'll do our window filaments on the back. And then we'll assemble the model. And we'll do it right here, probably at the airbrush desk. We got good light, a good picture, and it's comfortable up here. So we're going to try it from right here, everybody. Thank you for joining our premiere. If I'm not mistaken, depending upon if I've changed my plans or not, you are currently watching episode 17 of Foamer Friday, and tonight's episode is a premiere. I should be in the chat, and hopefully we're all having a good Friday evening. Let's get to the work, everybody. All right, everybody, let's paint some walls. Start to, try to. Mm-hmm. friends. We'll let that dry, and then we'll come back in just a minute. Well, actually, we'll come back in just a minute, and we'll be doing the... try that again. Now we'll just hit a 3D printer. We'll come back in just a few minutes, and I'll do the frames, which will just be a second for y'all, a transition, actually. I'll do the panels in the frames while this is drying. Once this is dry, we'll do the panels and frames in the walls, then we'll flip them and do the windows, and then we'll put this thing together. All right, everybody, we're back for the final part of the assembly, and so the only thing that, I mean, and I think I showed this in an earlier part, but the only thing I've done so far is I put in these inserts, this chimney, the window frames, the window panels, I got the door in, I got the window filament on, and now it's just a matter of assembling it, and it is just an ABCD deal, so it's not hard. But I look forward to showing you a finished copy. Let's get to it. I have to remember keep y'all in the frame. I am gonna make some adjustments to the table up here, so piece A does not have the chimney. I made this wall 1/4 millimeter shorter because I felt that that was needed. And I'm wishing I hadn't done that. I'm gonna go back and put it back like it was.
Alright, everybody, we let it dry for about 10, 15 minutes, and now we are back. And you're going to want to put the roof inserts in. They have cuts in them, and they should make an eave like the roof. And your hole right here is going to match up with your chimney. Your hole right here will match up with the front. All right. Just down to home. All right. We're gonna put adhesive. And we should be able to get an LED in and out the bottom right there. And so what we want to do is make sure that you're on the eave. Wrong way. Make sure you're on the eave. I didn't think I was gonna have to make a roof cap, but I am gonna have to do that. I'm gonna go ahead and assemble this bad boy as is. Put him on the layout. I don't know that we'll see daylight through there or not, but I can make the cap. I'm gonna make a just a little cap for the peak of the roof. Try to just make it a couple scale feet on each side. It's gonna be hard to. Get it flat if it doesn't have much length on it. Is this supposed to go just like so? I'm gonna move, it's close, but I'm gonna move the hole on this chimney. First of all, I'm gonna make the hole on the roof a little bit more shallow so it doesn't go all the way through. And I want to make it a little bit wider so it's easier to fit in there. And I want to move it this way just a tad. All right, just towards the front so to line it up better. I'm going to put, I'm going to work on the inserts. They need to be larger and I need a cap. Now, I certainly